thank you, team four. Now, this chief guest for the evening closing ceremony is already in our campus. They are already visiting this Olympiad demonstrations. What is there? And once the chief guest enters, Ecosol enters into this hall, we'll be starting the one team is there from Talicherry, full girls team. They'll be giving their presentation here. And after that, we'll be starting with the closing ceremony. By the time juries can compile the results and make the results.
Not part of the competition.
This only four were part of the competition. Okay, all the trainees who are sitting aside, participants can come back to their original position there. All the participating teams has to be located in the allotted area. No, but now since it is coming, we'll to manage. Bring on the starter.
What we achieved? We reduced the errors, we reduced the time consumption by 70% and increased productivity. Step 11, regular implementation tools and increased data collection stratification. Here is our data for regular implementation.
Here is the data after implementing our project. This is the estimated cost of our project. In our project, we are using Raspberry Pi, camera, LED strips, and acrylic sheets. The total cost of our project is 3000 rupees.
Prevention for future. After implementing our project, we have made this chart to regularly check our project for any misalignment or any short circuit. After all, prevention is better than cure. Here is our milestone chart after completion. Step 12, follow up and review tools and techniques. We use data collection.
Review. After implementing our project, we got very good feedback from staff, students and management. Here is the feedback of students.
Our benefits. It is easy to use.
It is automatic. Reduces human effort.
Increase our productivity time.
Tangible benefits. Inspection rate has been increased by 45%.
Rate of checking each workpiece has decreased from 5 minutes per workpiece to 1 minute per workpiece.
Time consumption decreased by 70%.
Saving money from buying a CMM worth of 1 lakh.
Intangible benefits. Helps in building healthy relationship.
Personal development.
Job satisfaction.
Morale and confidence improve.
QC movement has been strengthened.
Tools and techniques used in presentation. Saving cycle.
Milestone gang chart.
Flow diagram.
Check sheet.
Brainstorming.
Photo brand manage method.
Stratification.
Cause effect diagram.
Character analysis.
Graphs.
Y-Y analysis.
Conclusion. We the achievers have successfully implemented a solution to our targeted problem.
As a QC the cycle of enhancement, we are coming to hunt down the problem and solve them in a professional way.
Our next project, we are working on our next project that students not in the machine utilization chart.
Now time for the live demonstration. Here we can see that the project is powered by Raspberry Pi, which is the language is Python interpreter. Here we have kept an object that is the key. It shows the length and width of the object. That is now 21.97, that is the width of the object, and 49.83, that is the length of the object. It shows accurate measurement up to 6 decimals. That is the same result as we get in CMM, that is coordinate measuring machines. We can save it. We can save up to 1 lakh or 2 lakhs of rupees by just constructing a 3000 rupees project.
Thank you.
Type of dimensions, like suppose that width,
yeah.
key has, suppose for example, normally key has equal width. Suppose on the left hand side it has less width, and on the right hand side it has more width.
Yeah.
So how we will detect?
Now we are using this as a 2D, as you said. If we change the camera to 3D and change the perspective of looking at the object, we can get the width, length and height of the object. We just need to change the camera and some few changes in the program.
Okay, that can be modified.
Yes.
To that.
Yeah.
And one more question. How it can judge whether that particular thing that, suppose that the surface is not flat, so suppose it is inclined, slant. So it will not take the correct dimension, it will just be the projection of that particular image. So which will be, the measured dimension will be less than the actual dimension. So how you account for that particular?
This project works on pixel per metric. It checks that how many mm is there in that pixel, which the camera is going on. If there is a slight, even a slight means taper or anything there, it will give accurate. If there is a 1mm or 2mm that taper, then it will give little change in the output.
So like this.
Yeah.
So it will detect this point and this point.
Yeah.
So evidently this length will be actually less than the actual length.
No, it won't be, because it is from the top. And,
yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Even if you see like this, it is from the top, the edges don't matter. The initial point and final point will be at the same point. Na? So the edges don't matter. If you take a means normally the places the mount where we mount the head, they are not in a much taper, they are in just a 1mm or 2mm that slightly.
Yes, so the taper is flat, but my job is like this, my object is
taper.
Yeah, then it will affect the head.
Okay. My second question was on slide number 44.
Up to 6 decimal, that you can see what is that increase in length or width of the object through environmental
energy.
Thank you, team 4. Now, these chief guests for the evening closing ceremony is already in our campus. They are already visiting this Olympiad demonstrations, what is there. And once the chief guest enters, Ecosol enters into this hall, we'll be starting the one team is there from Talichari, full girls team. They'll be giving their presentation here. And after that, we'll be starting with the closing ceremony. By the time juries can compile the results and make the results.
Presentation is not part of
not part of the competition. Not part of the competition. This only four were the part of the competition. Okay, all the trainees who are sitting aside, the participants can come back to their original position there. All the participating teams has to be located in the allotted area. No, but now since it is coming, we will be able to manage. Bring on the starter. Actually, Mr. Satoshi Ekasan, Vice President, Canfee Private Limited, is already in the lobby. He's going through the Olympiad presentations. Once he's completing that, he'll be coming to them. I request all the friends to welcome him with the NTTF plan. You please announce the
Ladies and gentlemen, we are happy to announce the arrival of our chief guest. Satoshi Yakusa, and we would like to welcome with our typical entity of clan.
What's your name? 1, 2, 3.
Thank you. Fine. So, in continuation of our participation and the dedication shown by the four teams, we saw academics, innovation, and creativity interwoven. That was what we experienced from the four groups' presentation. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this presentation, what's going to happen is something different, which has not happened in the past. The guys who presented here had some academic experience, or they put in a couple of years in the institute, and they came and presented. And now I am happy to welcome these young girls, okay? The women power, who are also going to showcase their skills. So, in turn, I am going to request you all to give a thunderous clap and welcome them to the stage. So, their voice is the great, young, inexperienced, but I think we should appreciate the sheer guts coming in front of us and showcasing the similar skills. Let us see their display. Thank you.
Learned judges, distinguished guests, the fellow trainees, good afternoon. Today we are gathered here to present the case study presentation of Quality Control Circle. The first woman Prime Minister of India, the Iron Lady, Srimati Indira Gandhi. She is our inspiration.
In the location, Srimati Indira Gandhi delivered a speech. From that, these words are unique.
You must learn to be still in the midst of activity and to be vibrantly alive in repose. We, Phoenix.
We are proud to introduce our campus, which is the first institution established by NDTF in 1959. Natoon Technical Training Foundation, Telicherry. Now NDTF has 17 centers located across India.
These are our guides. The ladies turn off NDTF Telicherry, our beloved principal, Lieutenant Kedar K. Linar. Our vice principal, Mr. Roshan Peter, and Mrs. Saraswati Bia. Our coordinator, Mr. Shijin T.P.
Our facilitator, Mrs. Prisha A.
These are our motivators. I'm happy to introduce the leading warriors of my team. Myself, Anita John, leader of this team.
Myself, Anasri K.V., deputy leader of this team.
Myself, Kripamur Vijay, spokesperson of the team.
Myself, Vishnupriya K.V., record keeper of this team. This is our team logo.
Our motto,
stay positive, work hard, and make it happen.
Our vision,
be a premier institution in technical training and education to create the most sought after trainees through customer focused program catering to the needs of society.
Our vision,
technical education for global competence.
Anita, can you explain what is Quality Circle?
Quality Circle is a group of workers who do the same or a similar work, who meet regularly to identify, analyze, and solve the work-related problems.
Dr. Taro Shigawa introduced Quality Circle in Japan.
These are the legends who introduced it in Quality Circle. Our journey.
Our journey was started on 6 February 2019. We heard 25 VGs with 10% of attendance. We planned 2 projects and we successfully completed 1 of it. We conduct meeting every Wednesday for 1 hour.
This is the milestone chart which shows the planning of our team.
QCFA adopted 12 step approach, the problem solving methodology. They are identify the problem,
selection of the problem,
define the problem,
analyze of the problem,
identify the causes, find out the root cause,
data analysis,
developing the solution,
find out problem results and overcome,
trial run,
regular implementation,
review and feedback.
Step 1. Identifying the problem.
Brainstorming is an integral QC technique for approach to various steps in our presentation.
Anita, what is brainstorming?
Brainstorming is a group technique for generating new and useful ideas.
And the types are?
Freewheeling method, slip method, round robin method and so on.
From that, we are using round robin method to identify the problem.
These are the 71 problems we find in our campus.
Step 2.
Selection of the problem.
We use round robin method for categorizing the problem.
We categorize the problem and the criteria of
A,
B,
category problems means the problems that can be solved by QCT.
B category problem means we can solve the problem with the help of other departments.
C category problem means the problem that can be solved by the management.
And A category problem means the problem that can be solved instantly.
The listed A category problems are
improper working or vices in workshop,
improper maintenance and calibration in lab,
difficulty in tapping the workpiece,
boats are not visible due to the reflection of light. The listed B category problems are
lack of waste space in classroom,
lack of space in tiny hall doorstep,
lack of chairs and tables in theory classes.
The listed C category problems are
improper alignment of floor tiles,
lack of projectors,
lack of shelf for keeping bags.
AK category problem means the problem that can be solved instantly. These are the AK category problems we solve.
Wires are not arranged properly in classroom before and after.
Chairs are not located properly before and after.
Punching machines are not labeled properly before and after.
Files are not arranged properly before and after.
This bar graph which shows list of various listed of problems.
A category has 28 problems, B category has 24 problems, C category has 15 problems, and A category has 4 problems.
For identifying the problem, we use decision matrix method.
Decision matrix method, we use 5 point scale. Most important is 5. Very important is 4.
Important is 3.
Less important is
2.
Minor important is
1.
Under the criteria of
safety,
time,
cost, quality,
and performance.
By using the decision matrix method, we find the main problem and the
difficulty in tapping the workpiece,
improper working of power plants in lab,
improper using of safety equipment in workshop,
improper sorting of waste materials,
improper working of equipment in lab.
For identifying occurrence, we collected data from 16 July 2018 to 20 December 2018.
As the parameter occurrence, we use the control chart.
By using the control chart, we find the main problem that we are facing in our canvas is
difficulty in tapping the workpiece. Step 3.
Define the problem. For define the problem, we use 4W&RS method.
What is the problem?
Difficulty in tapping the workpiece.
When problem occurs,
while doing tapping.
What is the problem? In the workshop. Who is facing the problem?
We, first year mechatronics students.
How the problem occurs? Misstanding of tap.
Tapping is the one of the most important exercise doing in our workshop.
Now, Anushree, you just said what is tapping? Tapping is a process which creates indirect threads.
This animation which shows how tap is entering to the workpiece.
In our first semester, we have an exercise in our workshop called drill plate.
As we told, the main problem we are facing is tapping. In this picture, we can see that the fourth floor is for tapping using MTETA. Our batchmate, including us, facing a difficulty in maintaining 90 degree angle and other problems.
After discussing about the tapping, let's find the problem by using flowchart. Step.
Pre-drill the workpiece.
Check the hole.
Clamp the workpiece on wire.
Check the workpiece if it is okay.
Clean the workpiece
if it is not okay.
Again, come the workpiece on wire.
Select the clamp. Fix the number on the workpiece.
Start tapping.
Check the angle if it is okay.
Continue tapping.
If it is not okay.
Check the tap angle.
Complete tapping. Remove the workpiece.
Check the workpiece.
Rearrangement 5 minutes.
Stop. Step 4. Analysis of the problem.
This is how time allocated for the exercise.
And the effects of the problems are
no proper output,
overtrain unit to complete the exercise,
excess are not completed,
excess are not completed on time.
Step 5. Identify the causes.
These are the causes found by using brainstorming method.
Honestly, what is Ishikawa diagram?
Ishikawa diagram, which is also known as Fishbone diagram or cause effect diagram, which is used to categorize the cause and effect of the problem that we are facing.
Dr. Kaoru Ishikawa introduced the Ishikawa diagram.
Cause and effect diagram consists of four heads:
man, material,
methods,
and mission.
Lack of skill and lack of confidence are the main causes due to man.
Material lack and such short tap are the main causes due to the material.
Improper tapping, wrong procedure are the main causes due to methods.
Improper handling and poor condition of tap are the main causes due to machines.
This is the complete cause and effect diagram.
For setting the valid causes, we use effective matrix method.
In this green indicate, yes, it is effective.
In this red indicates, no, it's not effective. And the selected valid causes are
difficulty in tapping the workpiece,
breakage of tap,
improper internal threading. Step 6.
Find out the root causes. For finding the root causes, we use by the analysis.
Difficulty in tapping the workpiece.
Why?
Improper usage of tap.
Why?
Lack of skill.
Breakage of tap.
Why?
Not removal of chips in the
room. Why?
Carelessness of students.
Improper internal threading.
Why?
Tap is broken in 90 degrees.
Why?
Misstanding of tap.
And the root causes are
lack of skill.
Carelessness of students.
Misstanding of tap. Step 7.
Data analysis.
We collected data from first year mechatronics students.
We used cumulative calculation for Roy Parent analysis step.
This is our Parent table. And the minus views are
due to improper fixing of tap in workpiece,
cumbersome process,
lack of time.
Our project goals:
to save time,
to reduce overtime work,
to get accurate output,
to complete syllabus on time,
to extend tap time. Step 8. Developing the solution.
By using the brainstorming method, we find a solution and a
design a new tapping jig.
Use vertical center support
by a tapping machine.
Design a new tapping jig and effects are
to get axis correct,
easy to run it,
save time,
accurate
buy a new tapping machine from outside and effects are
high cost, more than required,
delaying of doing work, unskilling.
In effectiveness method, it is green indicating is less effective. This red indicates is more effective.
By using the effective matrix method, we find the solution for our problem is design a new tapping chip. Step 9.
Find out probable distance and overlap.
By designing a new tapping jig, it shows a foreseen problem and solution.
Foreseen problem number 1.
Lack of awareness of training on using tapping jig.
And the solution is?
To teach trainees about the new tapping jig.
Foreseen problem number 2.
Improper usage of tapping jig.
And the solution is?
To make procedure list which shows how to use in workshop.
Foreseen problem number 3.
Fear of trainees about LPD.
And the solution is?
To conduct awareness class about the new tapping jig.
Foreseen problem number 4.
Mishandling of tapping jig.
And the solution is?
To fix indication code.
Step 10. Trial run. This is the trial implementation letter.
This is a DFMEA table which is design failure mode effective analysis. In this, the archival of the component is used under 125 which is acceptable. The archival is the multiple of severeness, deterrence and occurrence.
This is the 3D model of our tapping jig.
Currently we use tapper tap of static tapping which we locate inside the ball. Tapper angle is used to ensure with the right angle.
video, we can see that with the help of our jig, completing the topic. In this jig, the base plate which give datum right angle and the V groove given in the gate plate will get the top while entering, and also the V groove at an angle to accommodate different sizes of tap.
Tap jig help us to easy to handle.
Without making any mistake, we can complete the work.
It helps to reduce time, cost, and manpower. This is the application of application work. These are the cost estimate for making our new project.
Status before and after prior implementation of the tapping jig.
Time to inform one exercise.
Before implementation,
30 minutes.
After implementation,
30 minutes.
Accurate angle. Before implementation,
not accurate.
After implementation,
accurate 90 degree. Complete exercise.
Before implementation,
delayed.
After implementation,
on time. Step level, regular implementation. This is the regular implementation letter.
This is the following version, that is standard assumption of process we used and based in our workshop.
Different types of gains are tangible and intangible. Tangible benefits for time saving is, by previous method, time required for one trainee to complete an exercise 30 minutes. Total number of trainees 129. Total time required for all trainees 65 hours. By new method, we can save 10 minutes in one person. So the time saver for entire batch 22 hours. Our lab hour rate is 300 rupees per hour. So 6450 rupees can be saved. Tangible benefits for cost saving is, the approximate price of arts and MPEG, that is 930 rupees. In every semester, the average MPEG package quantity due to this problem is total number. So 11,160 rupees per semester can be saved. And the intangible benefits are, acquired more knowledge in small group activity,
communication skill improved,
innovative skill enhanced, team spirit developed, presentation skill will be improved,
improved leadership quality,
gain self-confidence. Step 12.
Review and feedback.
This is the feedback from our workshop in charge.
And finally, we thank our organization, Netto Technical Training Foundation, for investing on us their faith and relying on our capabilities. And also, we really grateful to our beloved principal, Lieutenant Colonel KB Nair, our vice principal, Mr. Roshan Peter, and Mr. Sarasvati Viyam, for giving us this time. And also, we thank the staff, colleagues, and all the people who had been our ground crew to attend this position.
I am proud to inform you that we were able to solve the problem by which we are facing in the workshop with the help of the QC tools. Thank you.
Wow, that was an amazing performance. So, we move on to the next event. We now request Mr. Venkumar and Mr. Christopher to accompany the chief guest and guest of honor to the dais, please. We are happy to let you know, amidst us, we have Mr. S.K. Saraf as guest of honor and Mr. Satoshi Yaku-san, Vice President Tehin here as the chief guest here. Before we hear from them, we wanted to hear from our beloved jury to share their experiences, because they have witnessed the show from the morning. It will be a good feedback for us to enhance our skills and present ourselves better. So we request Mr. Subhash Askali to present his observations here for us to scale up. Welcome to the dais.
The forum what the NDTF had done in view of making this quality circle formulated was a very prime one, no doubt on that. And I would see that such a QC circle will continue to be in TTF's academics in future also. I am happy that during our times such a system of QC presentations were not there. Then we feel enthusiastic that we too should have been part of that one when we were there on that. So I am glad that each one of them have done the very best way of presenting in each of their subjects on that. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. We would also like to call upon one more jury member, so that we strongly believe two heads are better than one. So we would like to have one more jury member giving his feedback to us. Please, sir.
Very good evening to all of you. So very good participation, presentation by this participants. I liked it very much, and I think there were very good innovative ideas, and lot of things. In fact, I learned from them. In fact, definitely that is a takeaway for me. So thanks for that. So the enthusiasm was very good. Energy was excellent, and I really thank you and congratulate you for this. Definitely the numbers will be there, number 1, 2, 3, but I think it will not matter. I would like to ask you one question. So now we have qualified the zonal competition. How many of you participated first time? This is your, maybe this is your second time after this zonal competition. But in zonal competition, how many of you participated for the first time? Please raise your hand. Oh. Some of them are...
This is the...
Okay.
First time.
Okay. First of all, then, very good. Unless and until you start, I think you will not learn. And some of the jury panels rightly said, don't be afraid of failures. Just go on. Sometimes you have to break the rules also. But right now, please don't break the rules. Now, maybe after gaining some experience, you can follow that particular statement. Sorry for that, the comment on that particular statement. But definitely, this is a good start. I would just like to mention one point. All the things are very good. I learned things. The only one, I will not say this, it is a negative point or something, but rather that was my expectation. I was expecting some of GD&T use, GD&T application, GD&T improvement, the use of GD&T symbols and in one of the quality circle. Actually, maybe that was my expectation. Maybe next time I can see that. And as you are participating for the first time, I would like to mention ek Hindi mein share hai. Shayad Hindi kuch logon ko nahi aati hogi. Sorry for that. Manzil to mil jayegi, manzil to mil jayegi, yun hi bhatakte hue sahi. Are gumrah to woh hai jo ghar se nikle hi nahi. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. That was really inspiring. And we will translate for in Hindi from Hindi to for some of them later. Very inspiring. Thank you, sir. With such distinguished guests amidst us, I think I should take this opportunity to give a short profile or insight into the background. So, starting with guest of honor, we have Mr. Sharad Kumar Sarath. Mr. Sharad Kumar Sarath, Chairman and Managing Director of Technocraft Industries India Limited, is holding a degree in electronics engineering from the prestigious IIT Bombay. IIT Bombay is a very big name. After graduating from IIT Powai in 1969, underwent 1 year industrial training in Germany until 1970, promoted the Technograph Group in 1972, and since then he has been instrumental in the overall progress of that organization. He is a personality donning many feathers in his cap and a very, very luminous personality. The moment I received this, a page full of honor. Okay, so to start with, he is the director of IIT Mumbai governing body. Next, he is the president of Indo-Romanian Chamber of Commerce, president, Confederation of Exporting Units, ex-president, Council of European Union Chambers of Commerce in India, honorary ambassador of New Orleans, Los Angeles, USA, director, Cotton Association of India, chairman, committee of International Trade and Commerce, Bombay Chamber of Commerce and Industry, chairman, Shanti Seva Nidhi, running vocational training and skill development programs in Murbad district Thane, Maharashtra. So this is a few. The page is full, so it could go on and on. Now I request Mr. Saf to share a few thoughts of his, and I request him on to the dais. My colleagues on the dais, friends from NTTF, alumni and students of NTTF Training Center. Honestly speaking, I was not prepared to stand before you on this dais, but I was told just about an hour back, but it's my privilege and pleasure to be here with you. I must compliment NTTF for holding such an interesting, interactive session on quality. Having run a successful high precision engineering industry for the last 40 years, and that too mostly devoted to exports, I must say that for any successful industry, quality is the most important issue. NTTF could not have done anything better than holding this quality circle convention. I am very grateful to Mr. Sir and his team for this enlightening convention that you have done today. I must also compliment the alumni chapter of NTTF Pune. It is my firm belief that the brand of our institute, and particularly an educational training institute, is built on the success of the alumni. I am indeed very proud that I am associated with NTTF, where there are so many illustrious alumni. Maybe they are not acknowledged in the newspapers, maybe they are not shown on the public platforms, but I know for sure that they are the wealth creators and they are the nation builders. In my own company, we have a large number of NTTF alumni. We treasure them. We see to it that none of them leave us for any reason whatsoever. And some of the most key persons are from NTTF. NTTF produces what I would say the real shop floor talent, the persons, the leaders who can create wealth for the country, who can carry out manufacturing activities. In fact, about 3 weeks back, we had director of IIT Bombay in our center in Murbad, and when he saw the curriculum, in fact he was to spend about half an hour or so, but I think he was there for almost good
2 hours, he went through absolutely everything in very minute detail, every laboratory, every equipment, everything he saw. And then finally, he said that it's amazing what teaching that you are imparting to the students. I must say that NDTF converts rural students who come with, let us say, a very rural background and converts them into world-class technicians. Our alumni are far from, sir, Mr. Christopher, I'm sure you have far more retired than what I do have, but I am glad that Pune chapter has taken this initiative, and I hope there will be other chapters across the country where such conferences will be held. I am also very happy with the right choice of chief guest. If there is any country or any human race that is obsessed with quality, it is Japan and the Japanese. So the real quality in the world flows from Japan, and I am very glad that we have a very right chief guest here. Friends, all I can say today is once you are through with NDTF training for 3 years, your future is assured. You have very aptly said that you make your own future with your own hands, and you have shown a great success in this. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind words. And I also take this opportunity to thank you for your continued support you extend to NDTF, sir. Thanks. We move on to the bigger part. So I am too small to move on to the bigger part. I call upon Mr. George, Vice Chairman, Alumni Association Pune Chapter, to talk a few words about the chief guest, Satoshi-san.
The best thing for NDTF community can happen so far in Pune is today's event. You know, highest precision industry in automobile is carburetor fuel injection system. Carburetors and fuel injection system. And fuel injection system is the future, and carburetor is slowly going away from the system. Mr. Satoshi-san, Yoko-san, is the Vice President of all operations in India for Kane, which is making carburetors, fuel injection systems for mainly for Honda vehicle, and they are the highest precision company, we can say, in Pune or in India. He has, you know that we must have come across many companies in India, but this is a company, every department is, head of a department is a Japanese expert from Japan. They are actually a Honda owned company. They are every department is headed by, the time for them is very limited. Myself and Mr. Shantanu Kulkarni, when we approached him, the moment he heard that quality is the thing which is required, and this function is about quality circuit, he readily agreed to spare time for us. His time is so precious, so busy man, and still he accepted our invitation, saying that he knows tooling is the key and automation. Without tooling and automation, you can't progress in any country. Any country can progress in the coming future. So I am very thankful to Satoshi Yoko-san to accept our invitation, and he will share his thought about few words he will say about what is Japanese quality and what Japan, what made Japan what it is today. It is their hard work and quality. And Mr. I invite Satoshi Yoko-san to say few words to this crowd, sir.